So welcome back all of you. So this is the first problem in the two hinged arch. A uniformly distributed load of 40 kilonewton per meter is acting on the left half of the span of a parabolic arch. The span and the central rise of the arch are 36 meters. The span is 36 meters, central rise is 8 meters. So we need to calculate the position, we need to determine the position and the magnitude of the bending moment associated with the arch. We also need to calculate shear force and normal thrust. Assume that the moment of inertia at a section varies as secant of slope at the section. What is that? Secant of slope at the section. So let us try to sketch the two hinged arch to start with. Okay, solution. So what are the details given? So you have a two hinged arch. Okay. It is subjected to what? So what is the total span? 36 meters. Isn't it? So if this is the center, from here to here, there is a load of 40 kilonewton per meter and this is 18 meters, isn't it? 18 meters. And what else is given? Rise. What is that? Rise. So if this is A, if this is B, and this is C, okay? So central rise. So central rise is given as 8 meters. Central rise is given as 8 meters. So now this arch is actually subjected to both horizontal as well as vertical forces. So that we need to show it here. So this is VA and this is HA. So this is VB and this is HB. Okay. Now every other thing is similar to that of three hinged arch. What is that? We need to calculate the reactions. We need to calculate the horizontal reactions, vertical reactions, and then we need to take it forward for the other parameters. Okay. Now, let us see. The first part is to calculate. And one more thing. One more is given here. You can see that. That what is that? Moment of inertia at a section varies as secant of slope at the section. That means, whatever the moment of inertia we are trying to take, we need to take it by considering it as secant of the section. That I will show you while solving the expressions. So first thing is to calculate the reactions. So what is the first step? Reactions. Reactions, and that is vertical reactions. So how to calculate the vertical reactions? Taking moments about A. So sigma MA is equal to 0. So what you will get? Minus RB into 36, isn't it? Minus RB into 36 plus 40 into 18 into 18 by 2 is equal to 0. So this will give a value of RB. So 36 RB is equal to 40 into 18 into 9. What is RB? So RB is equal to 180 kilonewton. Okay. Now, next. Sigma Fy is equal to 0. That means RA plus RB is equal to 40 into 18. So 720. And RA is equal to 720 minus 180. So therefore, RA is equal to 540 kilonewton. RA is equal to 540 kilonewton. Simply, so the advantage of using this concept is it is very easy to solve. If you can use the overall, you know, scenario of like considering it like a beam, it will be of very good help. Okay, so now we got RA, RB. Okay, now let us go back to the expression of how to calculate the horizontal reaction. How to calculate it? Integral MY by integral Y square. So what is Y? 4HX into L minus X by L square. So let me try to write that. So you can see that Y is equal to 4HX into L minus X by L square. So this is the expression. So given H is equal to 8 meters, that is the central rise. So central rise is already given as 8 meters and L is equal to 36 meters. So therefore, Y is equal to 4 into 8 into X into 36 minus X by 36 square. So therefore, Y is equal to 32X into 36 minus X by 36 square. So Y is equal to how much? 2X into 36 minus X by 81. So here it will get cancelled. So that's why 1881. So this is how we get the value of Y. Now, for a parabolic arch, integral y square ds is required. So what do we need to do? So that implies this is 0 to L. Now what is the total length? 36. So we need to substitute and get the values carefully. So integral 0 to 36, 2x into 36 minus x by 81 whole square into dx. See, it is all about integration. It is all about integration. We are not even using any other methodology, any other complicated process other than using the integration part. So let us try to integrate this. So this is equal to integral 0 to 36, 4x square into, so 36 into 36. So we need to substitute the value to get how much is the overall area or overall parameter for y square dx. So 36 square is 1296. So 1296 plus x square minus 72x by 81 square. What is that? 81 square. So what is 81 square? 6561. 6561 dx. Okay. Now I'll bring 6561 out. 1 by 6561. Integral 0 to 36. 1296 into 4x square. So 1296 into 4, 5184. So 5184 x square plus 4x power 4 minus 288 x cube into dx. Isn't it? Now when we integrate, that is equal to 1 by 6561 integral 0 to 36. So now we are integrating anyways. So when we integrate, I will put it like, so we see here 5184 x cube by 3. Okay. 5184 x cube by 3. See, 5184 x cube by 3 plus how much? 4x power 5 by 5. 4x power 5 by 5 minus 288 x power 4 by 4. x power 4 by 4 This is within the range 0 to 36. So once we substitute, y square ds is equal to 1 by 6561 into 5184 into 36 cube by 3 plus 4 into 36 whole power 5 by 5 minus 288 into 36 whole power 4 by 4. So that equals to how much? So when we calculate, you will get it as 1228.8. Okay. So this is how we need to solve. Now, what else we need? Now we got the denominator. We got the denominator and we need the numerator now. What is numerator? Integral m, moment at any given section x. Okay, let us calculate that now. So now let us try to proceed ahead with the calculation of moment. So this is the third step. So what is the second step? This is second step. The third step, integral m dx or ds, integral 0 to L. That is moment at any given section x of 2-hinged arch, at any given section of the arch. Okay, now, so moving ahead, I will try to sketch this arch again for a better clarity. So we got VA as 540, this as 180, and here we have the load 40 kilonewton per meter. This is 8 meter. This is A, this is B, and this is C. Now, if you take any section X, okay, if you take any section X, bending moment at portion AC of the arch at a distance X. So, moment at a distance X from A for the portion AC. For the portion AC. So let me take a small section X. Okay. Now what will happen the moment? So MX is equal to RA into RVA into X minus 40X square by 2. So that is equal to 540x minus 20x square over. Okay. Now this is for portion AC. Let us take BC. We take BC. Let us take this as X. And see what will happen. MX is equal to directly RB into X, or VB into X. So that is equal to 180 into X. Now we need to integrate. Therefore, integral 0 to L M DS is equal to integral 0 to 18. So this is for portion AC. 540X minus 20x square plus integral 0 to 18, 180x dx. Here also dx. So this is for what? This is for AC and this is for BC. Okay. Now, next step. Therefore, integral M 0 to L ds is equal to, it's a simple calculation overall. So 540x, by the way, there is one more thing, into y will be there, ms into y dx. I forgot to write it. This is m into y. Just a second. Yeah, so this is m into y. So here also m into y. So here also m into y. So that implies integral 0 to L 540x minus 20x square. What is y? 4hx into L minus x by x square. That is equal to 2x into 36 minus x by 81 dx. So this is 0 to 18 plus integral 0 to 18 180x into 2x into 36 minus x by 81 dx. So we need to do some, you know, mathematical calculation here to get the solution ultimately. So we need to add, you know, all those things should be carried out. So this will imply is equals to integral 0 to 18. Okay. So I'm writing the final expressions of whatever we are going to get. 540x minus 20x square. 540x minus 20x square into 72x minus 2x cube. This is when we take this 1 by 81 out completely. Okay, 1 by 81, we have taken it completely out. So what will happen? So plus, this is dx, plus similarly integral 0 to 18, 180x into 72x minus 2x cube dx. Okay. So this is basic integration. We should be very careful of not calculating, you know, in a wrong way. We have to be very careful in solving it. So when we substitute it, integral 0 to 18, 38,880 x square minus 1080x cube. And once we calculate minus 1440x cube, we are adding both parameters, plus 40x power 4 dx plus integral 0 to 18, the second parameter, 12960x square minus 360x cube dx. So here we have 1 by 81 overall. So that implies when we integrate it, and we integrate it, 1 by 81 into 38880 x cube by 3 minus 1080 x power 4 by 4 minus 1440 x power 4 by 4 plus 40 x power 5 by 5, and I'm adding this also because limits are same, plus 12960 x cube by 3 minus 360 x power 5 by 5. This is 0 to 18. So you will get this value as 4,97,664. So this value will be, when you substitute 18 and all, 497,664. So integral m y ds is equal to 497,664. Now what do we calculate? So therefore, horizontal reaction H is equal to integral M into Y ds divided by integral Y square ds. So that is equal to 497,664 divided by Y square. We have already got 1228.8. So therefore, H is equal to 405 kilonewton. So this is the value of H. Okay. In the next class, we will see how to solve shear force and normal thrust associated with this problem. Okay. So thank you all for your patient hearing, and we will meet in the next session. See you. Thank you.